Welcome to Windsor. Thank you for joining us for our Reader's Theater. This is the third, fourth, and fifth grade students from Ms. Curtis and Ms. Carroll's classes. This is our sixth production. Today's show is written by Ms. Carla Baez, and I'd like to introduce Mark Way Morris. He is our student director this year. And when Ms. Carla had to be called out or students need directing, Mark created a fabulous job. So thank you for doing that, Mark Way. For the Reader's Theater, you will see students who have memorized lines, students that have cue cards, and then there's also students who have their lines whispered in their ear, but it's all about what comes out of the microphones. Just enjoy the show. And I think we're ready to start. Miss Tara, are we good?
Mike, check. It's always me. Check yours. Talk.
He's down. Oh. Is your name not yet? Okay.
Hello? Did you not trust me?
No, I didn't. Not after this morning.
Wasn't me this morning.
Oh.
I'm on.
Why did you do the sound? I wanted to let you know our unit was all about fiction, and we learned about hero villains in comic books. If you visit the corner back on this side of the gym, you'll be seeing the comic book section. On this side of the gym, we talked about fairy tales, and one of the things that we did was put fairy tale characters on trial. So the three pigs. If you guys don't mind helping us get chairs for them, thank you. The three pigs were on trial versus the big bad wolf, and they talked about point of view and whose point of view was the best or the correct. So that was a lot of fun. But the students learned all about things that were fiction-wise. So please look at our fairy tales and join us for the cast party afterwards.
Hello.
Thank you.
Hello.
Is that a yes?
Yes,
that's
a yes.
All right.
Am I on?
Hello?
You're on.
Carla, you can grab
your ladder. Let's shop again.
Not so long ago, and not so far away, there lived a young lady with a heart of gold named Cinderella. Not so long ago, and not so far away, there lived a young lady with a heart of gold named Cinderella. Cinderella lived in a small corner of a small room by a small fireplace in a big house with her stepmother, Eveline, and her two step-siblings, Grouchella and Grumpy. hearts were dark and as cold as ice. They treated her so mean.
Yeah.
Cinderella, shine the shoes.
Cinderella, clean her room.
Cinderella did everything they told her to do and so much more when she was all alone by the fireplace. She would turn on her music and dance. She danced gracefully.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay. And I pity any girl who's in need today. I feel charming, oh so charming. It's alarming how charming I feel. And so pretty that I hardly can believe I'm real.
Or... Or she would race the animals in the woods by her house. Because they all loved her. She was swift and fast. Or she would sit and read books for hours and dream about traveling to faraway places that she read about. She would say,
"One away, I'm one away from this place."
But it seemed that every time she could begin to dream of a better life or fun things or getting away, her thoughts would be interrupted by her family's demands.
Four. Watch the window.
Lock my door.
And she would work all day and all night, but she still managed to dance around and sing and be in a good mood. Now, on the other side of town, there was a different type of family, because all families are different, and...
Different is okay.
Different is wonderful. Different makes the world a better place. This family had a mom named Queen, a father named King, and a son named Prince. Their last name was Charming. Prince was a nice young man, and his heart was true blue. Mr. Charming had a strong, but sometimes stubborn heart, and Mrs. Charming had a heart that was soft and warm. The Charmings owned Charming Cupcake Creations. They lived in a big, beautiful home that looked like a castle. All three enjoyed spending time together when it came to everything except Prince's life.
Let's get started. Yes, what?
They would have this conversation often, and Prince would walk away and no one would notice. He would go outside and just run to clear his head. He loved to run and feel the wind hitting his face. Or he would listen to music and write songs, or read books, and find places that he had yet to travel. Maybe one day he would marry, but only on one condition.
When I find you, love, my heart will know.
So Mr. and Mrs. Charming decided that throwing a party was definitely the answer.
They were taking
and
flying
to Dan. And guarding and escorts and cars.
Meanwhile, back at Cinderella's house, Cinderella is cleaning while the rest of the family is just standing around doing nothing but making a big, big mess.
The summer comes to the door.
Cinderella was very busy.
Cinderella, my shirt.
She was ironing his shirt.
Cinderella, my dress.
She was sewing her dress. And she was bringing her stepmother her shoes. When she finished, her stepmom and her stepsister and brother were ready for the party. Poor Cinderella. She just stood in front of the mirror and pretended she was at the party. She pretended she was dancing and practiced her jazz hands. She pretended she was having her picture taken and practiced her poses. She pretended everyone was looking at her and she practiced her princess wave. Then she sat in her rocking chair and fell asleep. She was having a wonderful dream when all of a sudden, a noise and a bright light woke her up. She was frightened, and then she was amazed, because when she opened her eyes, right in front of her was a beautiful young lady.
Who are you?
I'm
a god's sister.
My what?
Yeah, I know. Our ex. Baby. mother?
Well, yeah, kinda.
Is the creation.
Oh, okay. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. What a party.
This is great.
Cinderella went to change, and her fairy godsister sat in her rocking chair and waited. Meanwhile, back at the charming house, Prince was still not happy about the party.
Thank you.
and everyone.
Cinderella was good with that. She just wasn't a heels kind of girl. She loved the dress, and she also loved her running shoes. You never know when a girl may want to run. So she didn't mind that her fairy god sister thought she was different. Do you know why? Because all girls are different. And
different is okay.
Different is wonderful. Different makes the world a better place.
I'm running. How do you get there? Trim and bow.
Uber car.
Uber car.
And around the corner came Cinderella's very handsome and very capable Uber driver. And he took Cinderella to the party. The party was grand. There was music and a DJ spinning great tunes and good food and dancing, and everyone seemed to be having a great time. Run together one day. They talked and laughed all night and even raced each other around the castle. Prince didn't even seem to mind that Cinderella beat him every single time. They talked about their favorite movie. It was the best night of Cinderella's life, but all good things must come to an end. And Cinderella remembers that her Uber driver said he quits at 12. So Cinderella said goodbye to Prince and ran to catch her Uber driver. Prince ran behind her, but he got around the corner just in time to wave goodbye. He was so sad, but he tried to smile anyway. He had met a new friend, and he wanted to spend more time with her. But now she was gone, and he realized he didn't even know her name. His mom and dad were sad for him. Soon the party came to an end, and everyone went home. But Prince was not giving up. He had to find his friend and laugh and talk and run with her again. But he didn't know how.
Meanwhile, back at Cinderella House.
She was back in her own clothes, and she was thinking about what a great time she had had with her new friend. See, Cinderella had never ever been able to run like that with anyone before because she was always working, and it felt amazing. She wished she could live that night over and over again. Just as she was about to think about their race again, her stepmother and step-siblings started bossing her around.
Yes, stepmother.
Cinderella, my tail.
Come here, Grumpy.
Cinderella, my cold now.
It's a new boot.
Cinderella wished she could get away again, but she knew she couldn't. So she just tried to be nice.
How was the party?
Good. They all like me.
The prince likes me.
The boss, the net, the weather.
Ben! Stop! No!
Cinderella just shook her head because she knew they were wrong and she had had a great time herself. The next day was all over social media. Everyone was on their phones tweeting and texting. Prince Charming, the heir to the cupcake throne, was looking for someone. Not just anyone, but a very special someone. He was looking for a beautiful young lady who loved music and daydreaming, and who could run like the wind. He put it on Facebook, and on Twitter, and on Instagram. He put it on billboards on the highway. He put it in the newspapers. Every girl in the city was excited. They all wanted to be the girl that Prince Charming was looking for. They didn't realize that the prince had a very special girl in mind. Prince was looking for the beautiful girl that he knew would make a great friend. The girl he had met at the party. He was looking for a forever friend. Someone who didn't mind that he liked different things. Someone who knew that it was okay to be different because...
Different is okay. Different is okay.
Different is wonderful. Different makes the world a better place. Girls started running and listening to music and trying to become the girl the prince was looking for. When Grouchella tried to sing, she couldn't, and neither could the other girls. Everywhere the prince would go, there were girls trying to run around him or sing around him, but none of them was that girl. He was starting to give up, and then one day, he went to the park to get away from everybody. He sat under his favorite tree, started to read a book while he listened to his favorite song. After a while, Cinderella came to the same park to run, and she sat under her favorite tree and read a book while she listened to her favorite song and started to sing. tree and saw each other and smiled. The prince had found her, and she had found him. They hugged, and they talked, and they laughed, and they ran, and nothing else mattered. Their hearts had found each other. Cinderella and Prince went away to train together. Cinderella became an Olympic runner. Prince became her trainer, and they became the best of friends. It was a different ending than most, but they were very happy because they knew that their story was theirs alone and couldn't be written by anyone else. Yes, it was different, but different is wonderful. Different makes
again, thank you so much, kindergarten. I appreciate it.